father who knows us completely to pour out the prayers of our hearts. You are faithful to listen and full of compassion, a friend when the journey gets hard. For to you our hearts are laid open, so we come as we are when we sing. From you no secrets are hidden, so in worship we'll bring you everything. When our doubts overwhelm us, help us to seek you, to bring all our questions and fears. Give us strength to be honest, you know all our weakness. Lord Jesus, you cried these same tears. For to you our hearts are laid open, so we come as we are when we sing. From you no secrets are seem unanswered, and silence surrounds us. The comfort, a spirit of truth. For you never will leave us and never forsake us. You promise that you'll see us through. For to you our hearts are laid open.
Good evening and welcome to St. Margaret's on this Friday afternoon. We trust your day has gone well, and we come from the events of our day to pause and spend this time coming before God in prayer and hearing God's word. It's good to welcome you wherever you may be joining us. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Peace to those who are far off.
Peace to those who are near.
Glory to God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit,
as in the beginning, so now and forever.
Amen. Our opening canticle, The Lord's Servant. We say it together. He was despised. He was rejected. A man of sorrows, acquainted with grief, as one from whom people hide their faces. He was despised, and we esteemed him not. Ours were the sufferings he bore, ours the torments he endured. While we thought he was being punished, struck by God and brought low, he was pierced for our sins, bruised for no fault but ours. His punishment has won our peace, and by his wounds we are healed. We had all strayed like sheep, all taking our own way, but the Lord laid on him the guilt of us all. The day is now past, the night is at hand. Let us pray with one heart and mind. Father of lights, receive the prayer and praise we offer you as our evening sacrifice. Make us a light for all the world, delivered by your goodness from all the works of darkness, through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord. Amen. Our psalm for this evening is Psalm 10. We say by alternate verses. Why do you stand far off, O Lord? Why do you hide your face in time of need? The ungodly in their pride persecute the poor. Let them be caught in the schemes they have devised. For the ungodly boast of their heart's desire. They grasp at profit. They spurn and blaspheme the Lord. They say in their arrogance, God will not avenge. There is no God, is all their thought. They are settled in all their ways. Your statutes, O Lord, are far above them, and they do not see. They snort defiance at their enemies. They say in their heart, I shall never be shaken. I shall walk secure from anyone's curse. Their mouths are full of oppression and deceit. Mischief and wickedness lie under their tongue. They skulk about in the villages and secretly murder the innocent. Their eyes watch out for the helpless. They lurk concealed like a lion in a thicket. They lie in wait to seize upon the poor. They lay hold on the poor. They drag them off in their nets. The upright are crushed and humbled before them, and the helpless fall into their power. They say in their hearts, God has forgotten. He has covered his face and sees nothing. Arise, O Lord God, lift up your hand. Forget not the poor forever. Why should the wicked spurn God? Why should they say in their heart, he will not avenge? Surely you see the trouble and the sorrow. You look on and will take it into your own hands. The helpless commit themselves to your for you are the helper of the fatherless. Break the power of the ungodly. Search out their wickedness till it is found no more. The Lord is king forever and ever. The heathen have perished from his land. You have heard the longing of the meek. O Lord, you turned your ear to their heart's desire.
To help the poor and the fatherless to their right,
that they may no more be terrified from their land. And we pray. Holy Spirit, sanctify, cleanse us from all hypocrisy, unite us to one another in the bonds of peace and love, and confirm us in holiness through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Our Old Testament reading is Jeremiah chapter 27, beginning at verse 12. I spoke to King Zedekiah of Judah in the same way. Bring your necks under the yoke of the king of Babylon and serve him and his people and live. Why should you and your people die by the sword, by famine, and by pestilence, as the Lord has spoken, concerning any nation that will not serve the king of Babylon? Do not listen to the words of the prophets who are telling you not to serve the king of Babylon, for they are prophesying a lie to you. I have not sent them, says the Lord, but they are prophesying falsely in my name. With the result, I will drive you out and you will perish. you and the prophets who are prophesying to you. Then I spoke to the priests and to all the people, saying, thus says the Lord, do not listen to the words of the prophets who are prophesying to you, saying, the vessels of the Lord's house will soon be brought back from Babylon, for they are prophesying a lie to you. Do not listen to them. Serve the king of Babylon and live. Why should this city become a desolation? If indeed they are prophets, and if the word of the Lord is with them, then let them intercede with the Lord of hosts, that the vessels left in the house of the Lord, in the house of the king of Judah, and in Jerusalem, may not go to Babylon. For thus says the Lord of hosts, concerning the pillars, the sea, the stands, and the rest of the vessels that are left in this city, which King Nebuchadnezzar of Babylon did not take away when he took into exile from Jerusalem to Babylon King Jeconiah, son of Jehoiakim of Judah, and the nobles of Judah and Jerusalem. Thus says the Lord of hosts, the God of Israel, concerning the vessels left in the house of the Lord, in the house of the king of Judah, and in Jerusalem. They shall be carried to Babylon, and there they shall stay until the day when I give attention to them, says the Lord. Then I will bring them up and restore them to this place. In that same year, at the beginning of the reign of King Zedekiah of Judah, in the fifth month of the fourth year, the prophet Hananiah of Azur from Gibeon spoke to me in the house of the Lord, in the presence of the priests and all the people, saying, thus says the Lord of hosts, the God of Israel, I have broken the yoke of the king of Babylon. Within 2 years I will bring back to this place all the vessels of the Lord's house, which King Nebuchadnezzar of Babylon took away from this place and carried to Babylon. I will also bring back to this place King Jeconiah, son of Jehoiakim of Judah, and all the exiles from Judah who went to Babylon, says the Lord, for I will break the yoke of the king of Babylon. Hear the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The second reading tonight is taken from the book of Hebrews, chapter 6, verses 9 to 18. Even though we speak in this way, beloved, we're confident of better things in your case, things that belong to salvation. For God is not unjust. He will not overlook your work and the love that you showed for his sake in serving the saints, as you still do. And we want each one of you to show the same diligence so as to realize the full assurance of hope to the very end, so that you may not become sluggish, but imitators of those who through faith and patience inherit the promises. When God made a promise to Abraham, because he had no one greater by whom to swear, he swore by himself, saying, I will surely bless you and multiply you. And thus Abraham, having patiently endured, obtained the promise. Human beings, of course, swear by someone greater than themselves, and an oath given as confirmation puts an end to all dispute. In the same way, when God desired to show even more clearly to the heirs of the promise the unchangeable character of his purpose, he guaranteed it by an oath, so that through two unchangeable things, in which it is impossible that God would prove false, we who have taken refuge might be strongly encouraged to seize the hope set before us. May your word live in us and bear much fruit to your glory.
Thanks, John. So we come to the second of our canticles, a song to the Lamb. We say together, you are worthy, our Lord and God, to receive glory and honour and power, for you have created all things, and by your will they have their being. You are worthy, O Lamb, for you were slain, and by your blood you ransomed for God saints from every tribe and language and nation. You have made them to be a kingdom and priests, serving our God, and they will reign with you upon the earth. To the one who sits on the throne and to the Lamb be glory and
be blessing
and honour and glory and might forever and ever. Amen. Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Almighty and everlasting God, you hate nothing that you have made, and you forgive the sins of all who are penitent. Create and make in us new and contrite hearts that we, worthily lamenting our sins and acknowledging our wretchedness, may obtain of you, the God of all mercy, perfect remission and forgiveness, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And the prayer of the week. O Lord, who for our sake fasted 40 days and 40 nights, give us grace to use such abstinence that our flesh, being subdued to the Spirit, we may ever obey your godly will in righteousness and true holiness. To your honour and glory, who lives and reigns with the Father and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and for ever. Amen.
Amen.
Tonight we share with the Anglican Communion around the world in praying for the Diocese of Rajasthan, part of the United Church of North India. We uphold to you, Father, the bishops, clergy and people of that diocese. Surround them with your protection, your wisdom. Strengthen their faith communities as they live and work as a minority in that part of the country. In Australia, we pray for the Diocese of Armidale, Rodney Chiswell, their bishop, for the clergy and people as they serve you in the various communities of that diocese. In our own diocese, we pray, Father, for the parish of Nanango, Robert Chippendale, their locum. In the chaplaincies, we this night pray for Brisbane Hospital Chaplaincy, for Cheryl Selvidge and volunteers, mindful of the great work that they do in visiting and ministering to patients and staff. Refresh them, give them your wisdom. In the schools, we pray for Cannon Hill College, Gary O'Brien, their principal, Brother Nathan James, the chaplain, Bruce Moy, as he chairs the College Council. We pray for the members of the College Council, the staff and students. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Loving God, we pray this night for the Diocese of Rift Valley. We uphold to you Bishop John Looper, and we ask that your wisdom and provision would be with him and his clergy as they journey through Lent, as they respond to various needs and challenges in the life of the diocese. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We thank you, Father, for the work of the RSL and other organisations ministering to the needs of the ex-service personnel of our community. And we pray for the gathering of RSL members and families this evening on their monthly get-together, that that would be a time of strengthening and encouragement of one another. We thank you for the work that they do in the life of our community here. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Loving God, we give you thanks for the weekend, the opportunity of rest and relaxation, the opportunity of spending time with family and friends. We pray your protection upon those who will travel, that all may arrive safely at their destinations. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We give thanks, Father, for those who work in the building industry. We're mindful of the myriad of trades and professions that feed into that work, from architects, engineers, draftsmen, builders, carpenters, bricklayers, plumbers, concreters, and a myriad of other trades, plasterers, painters. All these, Father, we uphold to you, giving thanks for their skills and the contribution they make. And we pray your guidance and provision upon all those who work in the building industry. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for our community, giving thanks for the place that you have called us to be as salt and light in the life of the community. And on this World Day of Prayer, we give thanks for the opportunity of gathering with the Uniting Church, or at the Uniting Church this morning, and pray your blessing and provision on the gathering at Holy Spirit Church at Brackenridge later this evening, that through that time there would be combined prayer to you, praying for the ministry of the church in Taiwan. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray together the evening collect. Lighten our darkness, Lord, we pray, and in your great mercy, defend us from all perils and dangers of this night, for the love of your only Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us praise the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
May the God of all grace, who has called us to eternal glory in Christ, restore, establish, strengthen us. To him be the dominion for ever and ever. Amen. As we come to the close of our time, we thank you for being with us and invite you to join with us on Sunday as we come to this second Sunday of Lent. And for now, we bid you good night and God bless.